All right, guys, we're back. Previous video, we were working on our main menu, so we have our front end up and running. Actually, I don't like playing in selected viewport. Let's do a new editor window. So we have our main menu up here. We can highlight things. We can't actually do anything just yet except quit. So up next, we're going to start working on the host menu. So when we click host game from the main menu, what happens there? So let's go ahead inside of the UI folder. Under main menu, let's open up the host menu. I'm actually going to dock this to the top because I'm also going to open up my main menu. And I'm going to copy this border just so we have something to start from. So I'm going to copy this, right click on this, copy it. I can close this. Inside of our host menu now, I'm going to paste it just so we have something to start with. Okay, let's see, let's move this over. It's also going to appear in the center, something like that. First thing that we're going to change is the header here. It's not going to be main menu. It's going to be host game setup. So the host game setup. Whoops, did not mean to drag that out. Select the border and move that over. So the host game setup. And let's see, let's actually kill everything below that, all these buttons, because we're going to add a bunch of different stuff. So I'm going to hold shift, select all of those, and delete. So we have our vertical box with just text in it. Okay, we're going to need some more text in here. So I'm going to go up here and drag some text into the vertical box. And this text is going to say, enter a server name. And for this, we're going to have it centered up, like so. If you want to change the size or color or anything, feel free. But we're just going to say enter a server name. Directly below that, we're going to have a text box. Not text, but text box. Drag that in. And this text box is going to be, if I rename this, hit F2, we're going to call this the user server name. So it's the user server name. And on it, we are going to make some changes. First thing we're going to do is add some hint text. So it's going to say something like, enter a name, dot, dot, dot. And it's very tiny right now, so you can't see it. I'm going to go to style, and we're going to bump the size of this up. We'll bump this way up to something like 28. So now you should be able to see it a little bit better. So it'll say, enter a name, something like that. I'm going to take this text now and copy it. And then on the vertical box, going to paste it. And this text is going to say, enter number of players, like so. And below the number of players, what we're going to need is a horizontal box. So let's go down panel, let's see, horizontal box. There it is. Take a horizontal box, drag that into the vertical box. And inside of it, we're going to have two buttons and some text. So let's take some buttons. And we'll have some text. And then we'll have another button. And then on each button, we're going to have some text as well. Like so. So it should be button with some text on it, some text, and then another button, like so. So let's rename some of these buttons and settings in here. So this button, I'm going to hit F2 on this, call this decrease players. And let's do the same thing for this one. F2 on this one, increase players. And the actual text that's on it, we're just going to use these symbols like that, something like that. And on this one, we'll change this one. Something like that. Now this horizontal box, we're going to center that up, like so. And let's see, on the buttons, we'll style these buttons. Let's style these buttons too. Can I do it at the same time? Let's see. Yes, we can. So go ahead and select both buttons. Just control and select both of them. Under hovered, tent, assign that yellow color, just so we have that same color. OK. Okay, and then the text in the middle, decrease these now, it's not going to say text block, it's just going to have a value for the number of players. So to start, we'll say we need a minimum of 2 players, something like that. Like super tiny, so what we'll do is for this, let's go to the padding. We'll add a bunch of padding around this, so we'll say 25. So it kind of stretches it out a little bit, gives it a little bit of a buffer. Okay, I think that's all we need to do for that section there. Let's go ahead and continue. Let's take this text here and copy this on our vertical box, paste it. And this is going to be, if we go to the details now, it's not going to be enter number of players. It's going to be choose play method. So whether we're playing on LAN or internet. We can then take our horizontal box. I'm going to copy it. Select our vertical box and paste it. So we get an identical box below it. And we're going to make some changes to this. So it's no longer decrease players. I'm going to hit F2 on this and say this is just toggle left. And this one is just toggle right. And the text in here, it's not going to be that. It's going to be, let's just say LAN. So, it starts out on LAN, then we can press one of these buttons and turn it to internet. Okay. And let's see, there's one more that we're going to add, one more horizontal box. Let's select our horizontal box, copy it on our vertical box, paste it. And for this one, we're not actually going to have any text in the middle. Like so. This is going to be our back and accept buttons. So let's name them that. I'm going to hit F2 on this and say back button. And this will be the accept button. So back and accept. Let's actually say that on the text too. So this will be back. And we expand this one. This one will be accept. let's go ahead and add a spacer in between these so it kind of fills out our little window here. So I'm going to go down to primitive and a spacer. Take that, drag that in between back and accept. Now I can select this and say fill. And it doesn't actually fill it. What do I need to? I need to actually make sure that that's set. Let's see. Do I need to specify the size? I think I do. Hold on. Let me look at my notes. I don't use spacers too often. So the spacer should fill. Not quite sure why that's not. Let's see, button, horizontal. It's auto. Live debugging here. Not quite sure why that's not filling. Oh, I think I know why. Let me see. The accept button. No, that's right. 1 second, live debugging. Why is this not filling? This should actually fill. Is that why? Oh, that's why. I thought it was already set to that. So we need to horizontally align fill. I thought it was already set to that, but it was carried over from the previous one, which it is by default, but we copied and pasted. So, live debugging there aside, I think we are done with our design setup. We might actually pause here since we did all the design setup. We'll pick it back up in the next video where we work on the graph portion of it. The next couple videos where we set up our front end are going to be like this, where we design it first and then set up the scripted functionality. So we're going to pause here. Our host game menu setup from the design perspective is done. And then we'll go into the graph and set up the scripted functionality. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.